Suzhou is located on the shores of Taihu Lake and on the southern bank of the Yangtze River estuary. The beauty of Suzhou resides in its meticulous classical gardens and delicious delicacies. How does Yangcheng Lake hairy crab turn into a snowball? Why did the French president give such high praise for pork knuckles? Cuihua will be your guide as you experience Suzhou's exquisite leisurely life and delectable cuisines. The written history of Suzhou goes back over 4,000 years. The city has maintained its ancient double chessboard pattern with the parallel and crossing canals and roads. The density of historic sites in Suzhou ranks number 3 in China, only after Beijing and Xi'an. Kunqu Opera, Yangcheng Lake Hairy Crabs, and the town of Zhouzhuang are Suzhou's three major attractions. The Suzhou cuisine tour starts with Yangcheng Lake, where we catch crabs. The second stop is a 100-year-old restaurant, which serves an authentic gourmet Suzhou delicacy, snowy crab meat. Then we travel to the city's new district for a taste of family-style cooking, and finally, we stop to enjoy Mudu Town's special fish liver soup. The humid climate nurtures abundant food resources in Suzhou. For thousands of years, a distinctive food style has gradually taken shape. If you miss Zhu Hongxing's morning noodles, shepherd's purse wontons at Songhelo, Huang Tianyuan cake, and Lu Yangsun's wontons, you can't leave without trying Yangcheng Lake crabs. As the Suzhou saying goes, when the fall winds blow, the crabs' feet are itchy. That means the hairy crabs in Yangcheng Lake mature in the fall, and fall is the best season to eat these crabs. Our gourmet guide Cuihua and tour guide Feng Chao visit Ma's Crab Farm on Yangcheng Lake, northeast of Suzhou City, as their first stop. Master Chun of De Yue Lo Restaurant is a renowned chef. With a history of 4 centuries, De Yue Lo was called the best restaurant in China by Emperor Qianlong of the Qing Dynasty. This time-honored Suzhou institution is renowned for its Yangcheng Lake hairy crabs. Snowy crab meat, a fabulous creation from the Suzhou School of Cuisine, was developed using hibiscus crab, making it an extremely sophisticated and complicated process.
你拆这个螃蟹非常熟练了，已经做了这个工作做了多少年呢？这是三年。啊，你说来做了二十几年了。那平均每天你会拆多少个螃蟹？拆一百多斤。一百来斤，一百多斤。
一百多斤，那一百多斤是什么概念？是多少个螃蟹？五百个螃蟹吧。
五百个螃蟹，你是每一个人在这里做这样的工作吗？也四个人。他要四个人左右。
每天工作多长时间？他阿姨说他们蛮辛苦的，他们每天早上七点钟过来出卸个蟹粉，要到出到晚上五六点钟。10个小时左右，真的蛮辛苦。阿姨，你现在用的这个工具是什么？
这个工具呢叫做蟹签。
蟹签。
对，专门是剔那个这个螃蟹身上白肉的。
Taking the crab apart is the first step in making snowy crab meat. The crab has to be separated thoroughly, and inedible parts have to be discarded.
阿姨，螃蟹有哪些地方不能吃呢？这个肺，肺是不能吃的，它是比较寒性的东西。肺不能吃的，对。还有吗？两边的肺，还有里面一个胃。Master
Chen has been working in the kitchen for 2 decades, and snowy crab meat is his specialty. Now he will demonstrate the key part, that is, stir fry the crab meat. The temperature of the fire and the skillful use of the hand are the two key points for this part. The chef has to be careful not to break the meat and roe apart.
Chen
师傅，我们的蟹粉做好了。蟹粉里面有什么佐料呢？我们这个蟹粉呢是用猪油加了葱姜炒制的。这个猪油，这是非要用猪油吗？对，因为蟹粉呢比较腥，用葱姜煸透呢去它的腥味。
那么用猪油炒制呢，使得这个蟹粉呢更加的肥，吃在嘴里呢口感更加的肥嫩、鲜滑啊！好香啊，炒出来的这个，快一下。里面还有一些那个葱花是吧？
对，
是葱花吗？
对，
像一个意大利面酱。
面酱。
The snowball made from egg whites takes a long time to stir. The key to producing the snow is to stir fast. The egg white foam has to be steamed as quickly as possible. A big fire is not appropriate for steaming. The right way to steam is to allow the cold water in the pot to release steam slowly as the temperature rises. Then the foam comes out crystal white.
我也一会儿来一个。这个蟹壳呢，实际我们是可以作为一种圣器啊。看来这个螃蟹的浑身圈都是宝。对。最后呢，我们装这个之后，我们把这个雪花放在上面，对，是吧？那么完了过后呢，在雪花上面呢，要浇一个明汁。
明汁。对。什么是明汁？很透明的玻璃嵌，让它这个雪花有点味道，因为这个雪花没有味道嘛。哦。
The crab's shell is a serving dish for snowy crab meat, and the egg white foam is like the foam that the crab spits out. This dish is a brilliant combination of shape, color, and taste, a feast for fall.
那我们终于可以开始吃了我们的雪花蟹冻，怎么吃呢？
那么首先呢，我们吃上面的雪花。
我在吃之前，我还是想说它太漂亮，就不舍得吃，因为这个白色的雪球下面那个贝壳是红色的，所以我觉得颜色搭配的非常漂亮。
这个蟹肉非常的香，非常的香，非常的那个肥嫩。
我告诉你，陈师傅，我都觉得我想天天这样吃螃蟹，太舒服了。
那么，但是这个螃蟹肉呢，也是不能多吃的，不能每天都食用的。那么，因为这个螃蟹呢，属于寒性的动物。
那一般一个人能吃几个？
吃一个到两个就可以。
1到2个就够了。